There are thousands of different species living in nature, and scientists continue to discover new creatures every day. The creatures living in the seas and discovered by scientists have interesting appearances. I have compiled for you the creatures that you will be amazed to see in the depths of the sea. If you haven't watched the first part, you can watch it on my channel. Marrus Orthocanna. Like a multi-stage rocket, this bizarre microscopic creature, Marrus Orthocanna, is made up of multiple repeated units, including tentacles and multiple stomachs. Technically, they are fissonect siphonophores, which are related to the Portuguese man-o-war. Like ants, a colony made up of many individuals has attributes resembling a single organism. Giant squid. The giant squid, Architeuthis dux, is absolutely the stuff of nightmares. The largest one ever recorded came in at a whopping 43 feet long, nearly half the size of a blue whale. Earlier this year, scientists created a draft genome sequence for the giant squid in a bit to better understand it. With about 2.7 billion DNA base pairs, its genome is about 90% the size of the human genome. Beyond that, scientists don't know a whole lot about the giant beast or its habits, because most of what we know comes from their carcasses, which wash up on the shore. Most of the time, the giant squid lives in waters so deep that we never see them, adding to their intrigue. Red-lipped batfish. This bizarre-looking fish is also known as the Galapagos batfish and can be found at the bottom of the ocean. It's named for its red lips, which make it appear to be wearing lipstick. Although the red-lipped batfish appears to have legs, its limb-like appendages are actually fins, which the creature uses to stand on and to check out its surroundings. Armored snail. There's no other snail in the world armored like the Chrysomelon squamiferum, which lives over hydrothermal vents deep in the Indian Ocean. It goes by quite a few other names, including the scalyfoot gastropod, scalyfoot snail, and even the sea pangolin. Today, its multi-layered shell structure is inspiring stronger materials, from airplane hulls to military equipment. Bioluminescent octopus. One of the few known octopods known to use bioluminescence, or glowing with its own light, the Storotuthis sirtensis octopus lives about 1 mile deep in the Gulf of Maine. It can position its photophores, light-emitting organs, to fool prey into swimming right into its mouth. Flamingo tongue snail. With a name like flamingo tongue snail and the flamboyant coloration to match, you might think the Siphoma gibbosum has a shell worthy of collecting. Not so. All of the flamingo tongue snail's color comes from the soft parts of its body, which envelop its shell. When threatened, it can retract its mantle flaps, exposing its true shell. Vampire squid. Strangely enough, this form of sea life is neither a squid nor an octopus, despite its appearance. Scientists have designated the vampire squid as a completely separate animal, even though it has 8 arms and 2 tentacles. Again, the name can be confounding. These creatures don't suck blood and actually are pretty passive hunters considering they're filter feeders. Instead, the name comes from the skin between its arms, which resembles a cape. Oh yeah, and this little dude lives in the pitch black waters of the mesopelagic zone. Coffinfish. Also known as the sea toad, these deep water fishes are relatives of the frogfish sea slide 3. These creatures have a small lure protruding from a depression behind their eyes. Coffinfish use it to lure prey toward them, and because there is so little light at the depths where they live, it allows them to quickly attack. According to Smithsonian Magazine, these fish also boast such sizable gills that they can increase their body volume by up to 30% upon inhaling a significant quantity of water. That would be the equivalent of a human inflating their lungs to become the size of their full abdomen, not exactly possible. Leafy Seadragon. Found along the southwestern coast of Australia, the leafy sea dragon, Phycodurus ikes, uses its fins not only to propel itself through the water, but as camouflage to resemble a piece of drifting seaweed. Because they have pretty big heads compared to the rest of their body, leafy sea dragons are able to concentrate pressure at their mouth to suck and prey. Similar to seahorses and pipefishes, the males carry around fertilized eggs. But without a special pouch, the leafy sea dragon carries the eggs beneath its tail. Blobfish, aka Fathead. Scientists call this fish Cichrolytes microporos, but also, more directly, Fathead. Smithsonian Magazine even notes that the weird-looking creature is largely considered the world's ugliest animal. But the blobfish is a pretty incredible sea dweller, surviving at depths in excess of 4,000 feet, where the pressure is 120 times higher than at the surface. But the blobfish is a pretty incredible sea dweller, surviving at depths in excess of 4,000 feet, where the pressure is 120 times higher than at the surface. But the blobfish is a pretty incredible sea dweller, surviving at depths in excess of 4,000 feet, where the pressure is 120 times higher than at the surface. But the blobfish is a pretty incredible sea dweller, surviving at depths in excess of 4,000 feet, where the pressure is 120 times higher than at the surface. Crossota Norvegica jellyfish. Known for its vibrant red coloring, the Crossota Norvegica is a kind of jellyfish collected from the deep Arctic Canada basin. It lives about 2,500 meters beneath the surface and uses ectodermal cells with nematocysts to sting prey. It's not exactly clear what these creatures feed on, but it's most likely a combination of zooplankton and phytoplankton. Yeti crab. This furry clawed crab looks so unusual that when scientists discovered it 5,000 feet deep on a hydrothermal vent south of Easter Island, they designated it not only a new genus, Kiwa, but a new family, Kiwidae, both named for the mythological Polynesian goddess of shellfish. It's likely blind and may use bacteria in its furry claws to detoxify its food. Jawfish. Let's state the obvious, this thing looks like it's throwing up. But what you're actually seeing is the strange mating process of the jawfish, a species native to coral reefs in the Caribbean Sea and Western Atlantic. Beyond using their jaws to scoop up sand, the males also use their huge mouths to carry eggs until they hatch. Still, other times, their mouths are like weapons used in jousting matches. The jawfish truly puts its money where its mouth is. Vigtorniella worm. What do you get when a whale dies at sea? You get a feast if you're a polychaete worm like this newly discovered Vigtorniella found about a half mile below sea level in Sagami Bay, Japan. Goblin shark. Long story short, goblin sharks look scary as hell. The super rare creature can grow up to 15 feet in length and has the ability to thrust its whole jaw outward in order to capture prey. Fewer than 50 goblin sharks have been spotted since 1898, so if you're hoping to see one, chances are slim. We have come to the end of the second part of the deep sea creatures you never knew existed video. I am sure you have not seen the child of these creatures that I found as a result of my research. Don't forget to comment and like the video if you want the new part to come.